Hi, everybody. I'm Mike.
I'm Matt.
We are Armchair Directors.
And we are Venom. Taking a look at the brand new flick, Venom, starring Tom Hardy, directed by Ruben Fleischer, who did Zombieland and then kind of did nothing but kind of garbage movies for a while. And they are brought this big budget thing that Sony is trying to expand the Spider-Verse without having Spider-Man in it. This will be a spoiler-free review, though. Check out our spoiler review tomorrow.
So, that's one of the announcements that we wanted to make before we get into this spoiler-free review. Going to be watching some more new movies that are playing in the theaters. So we used to do that back in the early days. That's when I had a steady job with steady income. And as nice as it would be to go to the movies every weekend, I've always placed paying my bills as a priority over paying for movie tickets. So I had a work situation, to be completely transparent. I was injured at my job and I was accommodated for a couple of years. And then one day the company decided no one would be accommodated, no injured worker anymore, no more accommodations. And that ended. And I really appreciate all the people who say, just go get a job at McDonald's. That's awesome advice. Thank you so much. Wouldn't have thought of that myself. But the fact of the matter is, physical disabilities will sometimes cut down on the things that you're able to do, even great jobs like the ones at McDonald's. So basically, it's been difficult to be paying for movie tickets, especially like, what are they, like $20 now? If you want to go all out with all the VIP and stuff, that's why I've been going the cheaper route with waiting for home video. And thanks to all our great viewers, our great friends who are patient and wait for those. But I found a theater, and it's actually my childhood theater. It was called the Frederick Twin Cinemas. Yeah. Now it's under Imagine Cinemas. And on Tuesdays, it's super cheap. It's about $4, which is amazing. That's Canadian, $4 Canadian, $4.50. Incredible. And going into it, I thought a lot of the viewers here know my trepidation when it comes to going to the movies, texting, talking. And I thought for $4, none of that will bother me because that's very, very, very affordable. And I'd like to see more brand new theater movies to talk about it on this channel. So I went to see this movie, and what really blew me away, in addition to the movie, because I love the movie and we'll get into that in a minute, was no one was texting throughout the whole thing. So here's my childhood cinema, which is still open.
Yeah.
You know, all decades later, and not a single cell phone popped open during the movie. And I hung out at the very back of the theater, so I can say I didn't see a single light up during the entire movie. People were so captivated by this movie. So
that was awesome. I paid $15 to see it in IMAX, and some dick took 3 phone calls during the show.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go. So that was an incredible experience for me. What this segues into is the announcement of the Armchair Guys, the Armchair Directors Patreon, which is going to be coming December the 1st. A lot of you have heard of Patreon. For those of you who don't know what Patreon is, it is a way of supporting content creators on the internet. So on my solo channel, which I do boys, TV shows, stuff like that. I've got a Patreon for that as well. We're going to be starting up a Patreon for Armchair Directors to support Matt and I doing this thing, to help us with the costs of running the show. And the major cost of doing Armchair Directors is movie ticket costs, which I've said, you know, isn't exactly easy for me at the moment. So rewards will be offered, as with a lot of Patreon platforms. There'll be different levels to suit your ability to support the channel. Different rewards. You'll be able to take part in roundtable discussions like we've done in the past, like the redo reviews, or take part in the commentaries. We just cranked out another commentary for The Karate Kid.
Yeah.
And we look forward to doing more, and we look forward to having patrons join us with those, because right from the onset of this was all about movie discussion, right? It's not about just one person sitting there and giving their thoughts for a couple minutes. It's about talking about the story, talking about how it affected you, how it made you feel, and doing a little bit of armchair editing and what you thought could have been changed maybe to improve the movie. what could have been cut out. So we're going to be launching that on December the 1st. And as the weeks go by, we'll be giving more details about that. So now that all of that is out of the way, let's talk about Tom Hardy and Venom. Spoiler-free review.
Spoiler-free, no spoilers.
If you haven't seen it, nothing given away in this review.
Yeah, basically, if it's in a trailer, we might touch on it, but that's it. Yeah. Now, when I went to go see this, I had waited a few days, and the critics really were savage. So I sort of lowered my expectations, and I think that can actually play into how much fun I actually had with this movie. Because I sat there, and there are parts that are objectively bad and kind of ridiculous, but I was just smiling the whole time and having a blast with it. Tom Hardy really gives his all to this. He just goes with it. He knows that this movie is a little bit ridiculous, but he's having fun, and just the commitment to the stupidity of some of this stuff and just the fun of it really worked for me, and I thought Hardy was great. He's probably the best part, because a lot of other people only pop up in this movie for a short period of time. Even, you know, Michelle Williams, you're just like, oh, she's here, and then she's not, and then she's here, and then she's not. And Riz Ahmed, I liked. He was decent as sort of the villain, but I kind of wanted a little bit more from that. But there was something about this that felt kind of like an old school throwback, almost as if, and I think this movie still was huge. It did huge numbers. But this feels like a movie that if it had come out between Spider-Man 2 and Spider-Man 3, it would have been like perfectly in line with those and like a phenomenon at the time. And then they totally could have brought in, you know, Venom into Spider-Man 3 and made it feel more natural than it did.
That's a really good description of it. I think it's really quirky. It's weird. Yeah. And I heard about all those negative reviews too, which a lot like Solo going into it, I think helped my expectations, because I love this thing. I absolutely had a blast. It was totally my movie. I love the pacing of it. It was a slow burn. Mm-hmm. It wasn't like a modern comic book, modern Marvel movie. This was the antithesis of Avengers Infinity War. This wasn't about boom, 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 kaboom, blam, fight, fight, fight. There's a scene or two in there that's sort of like that to satisfy the people who are very used to that and feel left wanting more when they don't get it. Mm. But this movie was so slow paced, slow burn. It felt like a 90s.
Right.
When we reviewed Han Solo, I said this felt like a 90s Star Wars movie. And I'm not talking about the prequels, late 90s. I'm talking about like early 90s if Timothy Zahn had written and directed it. So Venom, it feels like it would have been right perfectly there, a perfect setup for Spider-Man 3. I think they have really done the character of Venom justice. Going into this, I also thought, like, I wasn't hopeful about it, because I thought, how can you do a Venom movie without Spider-Man? Mm-hmm. And that really bothered me, because Venom is so like intertwined. His history is so intertwined with Spider-Man, the black symbiote Spider-Man suit. And then it goes on to Eddie Brock. So I got to say, before going into the movie, knowing what I knew about the casting of Tom Hardy, even before seeing him do anything, and then for the first few minutes seeing him in the movie, I was not happy at the beginning, and that totally changed later on. But at the beginning, I'm very connected to the iconic images.
Right.
Not characters who have looked like that for a week or a month or a year, but decades.
Right.
Eddie Brock, giant guy, looks like Brock Lesnar, ironically enough. Blonde crew cut.
Yeah.
Kind of an idiot. So Tom Hardy, not that at all. Kind of schlubby, down on his luck, loser, mumbles, but he was hilarious. And maybe it would have been better if they called him something other than Eddie Brock, because he's not Eddie Brock, but I loved his character in this movie. And I got so into his character. This sometimes happens when you connect with the character so much, or you just enjoy him so much, you almost start to act like him. So I was kind of like moping out of the theater.
Yeah.
And like, am I, you know, slack jawed? Am I talking like Eddie? Like, what? Like, that's how enveloping his character was for me. I absolutely loved what he did with his character. Eventually, like, and it is a slow burn. It cooks. You got to let it bake. But he is a genius actor. He's one of my favorites. And that's another reason why this was the first movie I saw at a theater in a year. I mean, the cheap price tag for the right. ticket played a major factor, but I wasn't going to just go see any movie. The last movie I saw was The Last Jedi, and I was satisfied with the theater going experience for the rest of my life after that one. But I thought, you know, Tom Hardy, you know, Fury Road, I wouldn't call him the best Mad Max ever, but perfectly, you know, adequate, serviceable, watchable, entertaining. And just like in closing about Tom Hardy's performance in this movie could have been way funnier with someone else playing Eddie. As I was watching the movie, I was thinking, man, someone else, a comedic actor, even Paul Rudd, maybe, could have been so much funnier in this role. But at the end of it, I understood and I got it. And I went, oh, it wasn't supposed to be funny. It was supposed to be weird and quirky and slimy and very Venom-like, very symbiote-like. So I always like to say when I'm recommending movies to people, you can't really do it justice. You can try to describe what happened in the movie as much as you can. But I like to use examples and say it's like this or it's like this meets this. So when I was trying to think of similar movies or properties like this film, I decided on, if you're a Tick fan, you will love this, because it hit me when the movie finished. This is the Tick in Arthur.
Right.
Tom Hardy is Arthur in this movie, the hapless, oh no! And Venom is the Tick. And he almost even speaks like him. You know, I want to eat people. You can't eat people. What about the bad people? Like,
yeah.
He's so, like, he's like the Tick in stature. He's giant. He's childlike. And he's proper. And he's powerful. And he's nigh invulnerable. And I just realized at the end of it, oh my God, I love this movie because I love the Tick, and this is what they're doing.
And I did think, I love that Venom is huge when he's big, he's imposing, and the CGI for the most part is pretty good. It's very true to like the way he was drawn in the comics and stuff, and I thought that was really cool.
It's dark, right? So that hides
it a lot of the, a lot of stuff.
Oh, you know, like.
Yeah. Like, there are a couple of moments, like when the tongue comes out and stuff, that you're just like, but it was fine.
Yeah.
And I did appreciate that it is a slow burn. In that first act, I was like, Venom's going to be in this, right? Because it's taking a long time to get there. And I'm like, wow, we're really placing a lot of stock on me investing in Eddie Brock being this journalist. And I don't know that we need to spend so much time on it, especially because as that storyline unfolds, there are a few times where I think like they cut a lot of stuff out of that first act, even though it's 45 minutes before any action happens. Yeah. I feel like they cut stuff out because there are moments where, no spoilers in this one, but there's a scene where there's a lab and there's somebody that knows Eddie and we've never seen that person before, have no connection to them. And I was like, what is, like, I feel like big parts have been ripped out of this movie.
And 40 minutes, I think, was cut.
Because when they made it, they were aiming for an R rating. And then, of course, 2.5 months ago, Sony got cold feet and they were like, it's got to be PG-13. So,
and I usually say, oh, man, why did they do that? It should have been R. That's usually what I say, like Expendables and a lot of other properties. Why didn't you just leave it R? In this case, you know, as a rarity, I'm going to say, right call, because it was so Tick-like.
Well, yeah.
It was so childlike. I'm like, don't go into the R. Keep it for kids, because it's a kids movie, basically. It's wickedly fun.
A scary kids movie, but...
I describe it as wickedly fun. Wickedly fun.
Well, and there was no point where I thought like, oh man, this would be better if it was rated R. But I feel like there must have been scenes that either had swearing or something else that just had to come out. And then as a result, they had to remove other scenes. So it was like a butterfly effect. But in terms of, you know, we don't really, they talk a lot about Venom having eaten someone's head and we don't really see it, but I don't think we needed to, you know. No. We can wait for the Blu-ray to see that if you really care.
And but, it's better left to the imagination, I think.
Especially because in the comic books, normal times, it would be out of the frame, right? So he would do something like that and it wouldn't be in the frame in all its glory sometimes. It would be like off the panel, you know, the ultraviolet. So it actually felt more true to the comics because you didn't see it. And I like that there are moments where people address like, oh my gosh, I think this horrible thing just happened, and we don't see it, but they just sort of mention it and then they just keep moving on. They don't spend time with the moral implications of I just ate someone's head as Venom. It's just, let's keep going.
And that makes it feel more like a McFarlane Venom comic to me rather than a Punisher Max comic.
Right.
You know, when I'm watching something make the jump from one platform to another, from cartoon to movie or from comic to movie, and I know we've seen Venom in another movie, but everyone wishes, or a lot of people wish they hadn't seen Venom in a previous movie, right? Yeah. This is the reset button, the second chance for a lot of people. And since they're doing that, I want to see Venom as I first saw him in the comics, which wasn't with, you know, major swearing and lots of violence and gore and stuff. That's not how he started. We'll get there. Just like the Punisher, when we first saw the Punisher in the comics, it wasn't R-rated. It got R-rated eventually, and there was an awesome incarnation of it.
Right.
But let's get there first, you know, because I don't think you can really do an R-rated Venom and then in 10 years reboot and go, this one's for kids. This one's PG. People don't really want to see you tame something down. They want to see you really crank it up. As far as the deleted scenes go, I don't really want to see them because this thing was long and I enjoyed it. I liked it. And it had to be as long as it was for that slow burn to have the effect it did. But I don't want it longer because it makes me think of other great movies I love that had extra scenes. And I decided, man, I never like X-Men Last Stand.
Right.
Or not Last Stand, sorry.
Days of Future Past, the Rogue Cut.
Yeah, you can read my mind. Yeah. But I love Days of Future Past, and when I watched the extended cut, I was like, ooh, you know, more is not more.
Sometimes. Never want to watch that one again.
So that's about all we can say about Venom without providing spoilers. It's still fresh and new in the theaters. So you've got my recommendation on it, Matt?
Yeah, basically, check your brain at the door and have a good time.
Yeah, fun movie, and we'll be back tomorrow with our spoiler review. So for all of you who have seen Venom, check us out tomorrow, and we'll be talking about the actual specific story elements, things that happen in the movie. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time.
Enjoy the show.